esportsbets.com, a unique place for true gamers. The only place to bet on esports events. You know your way around a competitive gaming scene and are willing to take a risk? Watch regular broadcasts and earn real money. esportsbets.com. Foresight, passion, and calculation.
And with that, welcome back once again. Here we have the second map between HellRaisers and NaVi. It is the SLTV Finals, and you're at Room on Fire with myself, Sam Lauren and Vendetta, of course, and we're really happy to have you. Just now, the players are joining the map, so we have a little bit of time to talk everything over, and, I mean, guys, we finished a little bit early because we wanted to go to a quick break so we can get back into it, but, ultimately, is there anything left to say about what happened on Dust 2? I mean, NaVi were just... they were looking too strong.
NaVi were definitely looking too strong on Dust 2. Especially, you mentioned that as the game concluded, really, that everything they did was just really planned out, it felt like. They didn't rush anything, they didn't do anything rash. It was just really nicely and well executed from NaVi all game through. And on HellRaisers' part, we saw a bit of odd buys here and there, which I guess comes with the territory when you're doing a HellRaisers game, but I think NaVi being able to just keep their calm and not losing those rounds where HellRaisers do decide to go for these surprise buys kept them ahead and gave them the distance they needed to close it out.
Yeah, and something we can't forget as well is that HellRaisers did go for a lot of force buys early on in the half, trying to stop NaVi cold. And it's a calculated risk. I mean, you're trying to basically put a stop to Navi's money as early as possible. You let them get the rounds, but you try and shut down their money. But it's a gamble, and it just didn't work out for HellRaisers at all. NaVi just powered through.
So the question is, I mean, Inferno is a very different map, obviously, from Dust 2. And, I mean, what we see from NaVi in the past on this map is very, very slow play, very often with the kind of pushes that happen when there's maybe 20 seconds or sometimes incredibly even less than that left on the map. HellRaisers, they have to know that. Do you think they're going to be able to exploit it? I'm talking specifically now on the CT side, of course, to maybe stop this. I mean, HellRaisers, they got to win this map, but they're going to be in the lower bracket with my XMG.
I definitely think HellRaisers are fully aware of how NaVi plays this map. And we keep mentioning it. Inferno is probably the most played, or it is the most played map in CSGO in tournament settings. So every team has a good feel for how every team plays for the most part, and everyone knows that NaVi likes a slow play style. HellRaisers probably have something to counteract that, even whether it be aggressive pushes early on in the round or just banking on solid setups for whenever the executes from NaVi come around, because as you said, they oftentimes execute on a bomb site with as little as 20 to 15 seconds left in the round, so they basically have to get a perfect execute onto that bomb site to even get the bomb down. So if HellRaisers have something planned, a solid setup that basically just allows them to just nab that bomb planner, that could be all they need, really.
Yeah, that, I mean, I think there's a real chance that HellRaisers can do this. They've been practicing so much, and I think they're actually a pretty strong team on this particular map. But as you said, it's not like NaVi aren't good at it either.
No. NaVi are very good on Inferno. We've seen that in the past from them. The ability for Guardian to make use of the AWP, not something that, well, it seems to be a little bit more common now with Kaylee and Kenny, I guess, the Frenchmen really favoring that sort of strategy as well. But it's like not per se like a Swedish thing unless JW decides to get involved. So like NaVi have Guardian to fall back on for some of that mid control or perhaps trying to catch HellRaisers off guard and banana. The question is whether HellRaisers really are going to come into this with confidence and start landing some shots, because I think it's really important for them to get a strong start here on this map. They need to pick up the pistol, basically, to just show, like, okay, yes, we can take these rounds away from NaVi. They are not invincible. They are not indomitable. We can do some damage here.
Yeah, and I'm excited to see who's going to pick up the AWP on HellRaisers' side. On Dust 2, we saw Markloff picking up the AWP. I don't think we ever saw Kucher picking up the AWP on Dust 2. But on Inferno, that's kind of been his map.
Okay, so after Gamescom, we actually, like, there was a tweet from Markloff, and I think this is something they've been working towards for a long time, I guess. It's like, just Markloff, is he going to feel confident being the point man for the AWP for HellRaisers? Because in the past, when we've interviewed the team, it was much more of a nip sort of thing, where it was like, okay, whoever kind of feels like it picks up the gun, right? Yeah. But Markloff, after Gamescom, tweeted, you know, you guys are going to see me on the AWP a lot more now. So I'm wondering if that means that now he is going to be that point man for HellRaisers. And, you know, despite Kuchar really showing that he can use the gun on this map, you know, is he going to be the one taking point for it?
Well, who's to say they're not going to go for a double off setup?
I mean, I hope they don't. I think that's a little bit too much. But I would agree. And it's not even because I think Markolov isn't good enough as an AWP. I just think Kuchar's style fits a map like this very well because he can hold angles for a long time on his own and you know, that leaves the rest of the team to do stuff. I wouldn't be opposed to them just putting Kuchar on banana or something and then just, you know, leaving everyone else on A. Not maybe every round, but for a number of rounds, that could work out. Before we get started, everyone, reminder that we do have this sub giveaway that we're going to be doing later on for this Cyrix that was gifted to us earlier. So really appreciate that, guys. Big thanks as well to anyone who's donating our skins. It's happened a couple of times. This one's from Stony Maloney, who already gave us a bunch of stuff. So really appreciate that, Stony. And that's for the subscriber team as a thank you for you guys, you know, helping us out so much here with the channel. When we're waiting for the knife round still, once it's up and running, we'll decide what side, you know, teams are going to start on. And actually, normally, I tend to say on Inferno, doesn't really matter that much who starts on what side, but I would love to see HellRaisers winning the knife round, because I think right now they need whatever they can get, basically, and starting on CT side might be just it.
Yeah, they got a pretty severe pounding on Dust 2, so I think they definitely would like to start on the CT side just to ease into things. As much as you can ease into anything when playing Na'Vi.
I mean, there is that. It's also, I mean, T-side is also just something. Well, how many rounds do you think HellRaisers are going to be needing to pick up on the, you know, if they were to start T-side? I don't know, it's a bit of a random early question to be asking. But,
5 to 6 rounds?
Yeah, you think 5 rounds?
Yeah, 5 to 6 rounds.
I'd say 6 over 5 right now. I'm not sure 5 is going to be enough, actually, but it will be Na'Vi starting on the CT.
Yeah, 5 in the pistol?
Yeah,
5 in the pistol.
Yeah, that should be more than enough.
I'll go for that one, yeah. All right, so here it comes. Welcome to the SLTV Star Series Finals. It's Na'Vi and HellRaisers now. Second map, with Na'Vi having already taken the first one on Dust 2. And you're at Room on Fire, so big welcome and a big thanks to everyone for tuning in. We still have one more best of three, even after this one, between Fnatic and whoever wins here. And that is, no matter how that turns out, it's going to be one hell of a match as well. So invite your friends, follow the channel, and let's get everything rolling here. Na'Vi going for a pretty standard setup with 2 people B and 3 people A.
Yeah, really quite split up, no problem at all. They are pushing into apartments, though, so looking to see if they can't get some information. Look towards second mid to see if they can't get an early pick here, and there's the instant headshot from Guardian. He picks up one, Edward gets another, and this has worked out marvelously so far for Na'Vi. They are getting cut off in apartments, but that doesn't stop Edward from picking up yet another headshot.
Yeah, Kuchar finally going to bring down the Titan here, but it might be too late anyway. Edward's got a double, Guardian's got a double, and that leaves Kuchar alone, and he's getting pretty much attacked from all angles here. He's going to try and fight his way out. Somehow Seast has killed Susan in a bit of a team-friendly fire accident, but it has no impact on the game. I mean, except for the funny fact that it put Caesar's minus one, but he had no money to lose anyway, so it's going to be just fine. 1-0 for Na'Vi.
That was a cool aggressive pistol from Na'Vi, actually. It had Sue's around an arch. Kitted out with flashbangs and basically flashed out Edward and Guardian. Up from CPL there, and they managed to catch 2 HellRaisers players almost instantly, and from that point on, and that was also Dojo's had the majority of nades actually on HellRaisers, and from there on out, it's extremely hard for HellRaisers to get back into it.
Yeah, I mean, I guess if they had quickly killed the people in the apartments and sort of reset it into a 3-on-3, there would have been some sort of opening, but that just wasn't even possible. So now, well, they're going to try and go for the A bomb site. All rushing in through quads. Seuss in the pit here. He's got to be careful. He doesn't run out of bullets, but he's got some good backup with him here. Guardian as well. The bomb is now dropped in the pit, so no chance for HellRaisers to get the bomb down easily unless they kill Seuss, and they just did.
If they can manage to get the plant here, that would be huge. But Angel almost getting sprayed down through the box that you can now wallbang. And it's a 2-on-2, rifles on Na'Vi's side, nades go in, and Angel's just trying to find a frag, but he's not going to get it. Seized and Starix will, I mean, pick up the kills, and that's pretty much going to fall apart now for HellRaisers. They come so close to picking up an anti-eco round.
That was a really weird decision coming out from Doja there, because they managed to pick up Edward, who was in castle or in graveyard, and the guy in pit was basically isolated behind the big post, right? So all Doja had to do was basically jump on site, find a corner, and plant the bomb, and that would have been a successful eco from HellRaisers' part. But he actually decided to dive down into pit after the guy behind, or yeah, but back in pit for no good reason, and that it messed things up for HellRaisers.
And they're gonna go for it here, actually straight into the bomb site, and Seized is gonna comfortably control the spray and take down Adrian and Kucha. They will drop him. Nice shot from Doja, actually really good headshot with just a pistol here. Starix is gonna go down as well, so there's another opening right now. Guardian so quick to find Angel in the corner, and Doja will at least get the bomb plant, so that's some good news for HellRaisers here. 1-on-3 though for Doja. Kind of unlikely that he can win it, especially because they know exactly where he is. The smoke here is gonna help him, and he's trying to guess the angle through, but Seuss will find it. I'm wondering, Vendetta, if the... I mean, what you said I think is true, not in this round, but the previous round, where Doja went in the pit. And I think at that point, you're basically making a decision saying, we're going to try and win the round instead of just settling for a plant. But that's a big risk to take.
Yeah. That's something you can work with, that even if you get the bomb plant up, because that forces the guy in pit to actually come out towards you. Sure, you might get sandwiched in, but then again, you are on an eco, and I think it's more of a risk and a bigger, it's more up to luck, I guess, for Doja to down a guy fully kitted out with a Glock than having some of your teammates back him up and actually double-teaming him.
Now, at least HellRaisers have rifles. It's the fourth round of the first half on this second map here between NaVi and HellRaisers, and they're on the less favored side, as we said, something like 5 or 6 rounds on this first half, and they can probably work with it, so... we shouldn't be panicking too much, I guess. But right now, everyone, I think, has that Dust 2 game in the back of their minds, right? They're thinking, is NaVi going to do it again? That's what I'm thinking anyway.
Yeah, there's that. But it's also HellRaisers having missed out on the opportunity to get easy rounds. Now they have to deal with buy rounds from here on out from NaVi. NaVi, they've spent a lot of money in this round. But there's still a little bit of a bank, so even then they could probably go for a force if they wanted to in the next round if they were to lose this one. So now it's all pressure on HellRaisers to find the entry frags. Edward waiting in the corner below short is going to gun down Angel. No work there, no problem, and they know now that they're going to be pushing out from apartments. NaVi know exactly what's happening, and Zeus hunts down Doja, make sure that the flank can't happen.
And I think that's really the critical kill in a round like that. Doja going down really, really leaves HellRaisers in a really bad spot here. AWP from Guardian is going to find Kucha as well. Now the two remaining players from HellRaisers are in the pit, and this is going to be almost impossible for them to hold this. Even Molotovs and smokes here, so they don't even need them to just shut them down. But if it had come to it, NaVi could have actually smoked on Molotov this whole plateau off, and they would have been stuck in the pit with no chance of getting out. So very, I don't know. I think that Doja going down in the middle, that settled everything.
And the strategy we just saw HellRaisers execute is something they've done for a couple of weeks now, and it seems like teams are extremely aware of what's going on whenever they see those two smokes that Adrian and Markelov throws come in. Because it seems like every team goes aggressive on them in the quad area whenever those smokes come through instead of being cornered in. And that messes up HellRaisers each and every time. That was actually the most successful round I've seen them execute that strategy with, because they got the bomb plant.
And that's not exactly great, is it?
Yeah.
Well, this time they're going up middle pretty aggressively through the smoke. They might be able to catch Edward here. He picks off one, and up on the balcony, it's Guardian with the AWP, and he's already killed one, and he's getting back up quickly. Not going to get that second shot off, and he's going to get taken down eventually. Seuss will get dropped as well. Great work from Doja getting into this bomb site.
Yeah, both of them tagged down to half HP, however. Angel does manage to do a lot of damage to Seized. Forces him back around the corner. That's from full HP down to 16 in the blink of an eye. Great rifle work there from Angel. But now it's going to be Starks and Seized both working together. They managed to catch Doja completely off guard out in the open on short. And it's all going to be down to Angel now holding in pit.
Yeah, he has to come up big here. He's going to get the one, but he cannot pick up the second one. And there's a team ace for NaVi. Every single member picking up a kill each. And that was very close. I mean, Doja did so much that round to make it work. They just couldn't finish it.
That's unfortunate for HellRaisers. If Doja picks up Starix there as the first guy coming in for quad, I think that's HellRaisers' round at that point. But then again, Doja did kind of save their bacon picking up those two frags as they were taken at site.
now, I mean, the money for NaVi, they just had a round where they lost four members, so it's a little bit lower than it otherwise would have been, but I mean, still pretty good. They can lose a round and still buy, and they're grenading Angel down, sorry, Kucha down, and that's actually Edward pushing up hyper-aggressive in the middle. Gonna take one kill. Doja could be falling as well, out of bullets, though, and Edward will drop. The grenade can't finish Doja, but, I mean, one for one, sure, but Doja's very nearly dead.
Yeah, you sneeze on Doja and he's gone at this point. I'm curious to see where, if they're going to push out anywhere. NaVi right now to try and get some info, because Starix, look at him, he's about to come in through B. There's the flash, and like clockwork, Starix picks up a frag. C sets it up perfectly for his teammate to get the info and get the kill. And that's the kind of thing that we needed to see from NaVi there at that point. In an even situation like that, 4-on-4, NaVi on the CT side need to figure out where Hellraisers are, but they do it in a safe way. So very fine work there from NaVi, getting control back in this situation.
Yeah, that flashbang trick is one of the oldest thing in the book, but it works so well, so I'm just delighted to see NaVi do it. Hellraisers, though, they're going to go back towards the A-bomb side, and because of that info like you were talking about, Samla, now they pretty much know, NaVi, that what's happening. They've already got almost three people here. Great flashbangs on Seuss, though, but the bomb has dropped down there, and the Guardian is going to pick off Doja. Now it's Adrian and Markolov left, and Markolov looking the wrong way at the wrong time. Going to leave Adrian alone. He's going to get down as well. That's Seuss with a double kill, so not much of a chance for Hellraisers that round, it seemed. Then, I mean, it started off with them being thrown completely off balance. I mean, Vendetta, what does it do to a team when you're trying to set up for a push and then all of a sudden there's Edward in the middle killing your teammates?
Well, this is what we talked about during the XMG game, Fnatic XMG. You start to play scared, and all of a sudden, instead of getting out on the map and grabbing the map control that you desperately want, you have to hold back and constantly be afraid of a wild Edward appearing in the middle of the map.
A wild Edward. Guardian did try to get a go for a pick in the apartments, like he's pretty well known for doing, and Hellraiser saw it coming as well, so he gets down to 16. And now he's got to be really careful. He's trying to shoot through the smoke, but if they throw a grenade or just shoot through, that could be a big problem. Edward up in the apartments is going to go for a kill here, but just does a little bit of damage, and he's going to get taken down. And a pretty much a perfect take comes in here from Hellraisers. That is the round they needed.
Yeah, two big kills there from Kucher, making up for the fact that he saved Guardian's life earlier on, because Guardian, he got headshot, and then Kucher stepped in front of, I think it was Adrian taking shots at him, at Guardian, and Adrian tries to hold off from shooting, from taking that final shot that could have taken out Guardian, because Kucher gets in the way. So, you know, a little detail there at the beginning of the half. Kucher, though, he realizes, and he gets two kills to make up for it, so I think Adrian can forgive him this time.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, right now, 6-1... If they can start to string some rounds together, that would be beautiful. Starix is going to pick off Adrian here, which is very annoying. And if he had got Doja as well, that would have actually been great from Starix. Just causing more economic damage for Hellraisers. How many rounds do they need to win before they can force an eco? Actually, look at the scoreboard here. It's mainly Guardian and Seas who have money. The rest don't have quite as much. So winning another round here for Hellraisers would actually make this, all of a sudden, sort of an interesting first half again.
Yeah, open everything.
Yeah, the opportunity to break Ignavi's economy is definitely there, but let's see if the trend of the day continues, because if it does, then NaVi's going to pick up a nearly flawless round now. So.
Yeah, that has been the theme. And look at another flashbang play here that they can do. You see Seuss by the graveyard? He's just ready and waiting, admiring the sky for a little bit, but I bet he's going to be flashing Edward in any second. That's, again, a very common play, but it's all about timing. And right now, it's very close to it. Seuss, is he going to get that grenade out? Be perfect timing right now, but he's waiting. And as they round the corner, he's actually going to pick up, though. That's Edward picking up the kill, and Seuss is now going to spray down, and he gets both the kills. Kucha and Markolov are down, and now he's going to re-peek again. Angel will drop him, and Guardian trying to mine the crossover here. The bomb is actually down in the pit, and now Angel's alone.
Angel's alone on the site, and Guardian finds the remaining two frags. But that was all Seuss just saving the day there. Edward, he gets rushed down, spots it out, but Seuss with the double spray, that M4A1, or M4A4 rather, just going to work there. So really nicely done there by Seuss to save the day, basically, because if he just goes down, if he gets overwhelmed, Guardian's pretty sure to follow suit, and then Hellraisers have that second round. But once again, Ben, the it holds true. You cannot win the follow-up round, apparently, versus Fnatic or NaVi.
No, and that's about as bad as it can get. I mean, we know we say that all the time, but the name of the game, whether you're on the terrorist or the counter-terrorist side, is consecutive rounds, because that's how the money system works. Right now, Hellraisers have their economic round loss bonus reset, and They're down to 1,400. I mean, they could force it up here anyway because they had some money left, but they got to start winning. And now it's critical. Whereas before they had an opening, right now it's critical that they start winning one or two or three rounds in a row here. Well, one round in a row doesn't make sense, but...
And the fact that they forced up this round makes this round all the more important because they're basically jeopardizing their economy for the rest of the half in this with this one round.
A flash through, and Edward's going to get caught. Great movement there from Doge. Just gets the kill instantly. If Edward had been allowed to do that, that would have been horrendous. Now it's a 5-on-2, in fact, so HellRaisers bounce back, and that's heartwarming right now. They need more of this kind of play.
Yeah, and this is just going to be NaVi now, just trying to back off and hold on to these guns, which is the right move to make in this point. I mean, 2-on-4 retake of A, just too many angles to be holding for HellRaisers and for NaVi to be checking, right? So if NaVi can make it out of here holding onto Guardian's AWP, that would be really big.
Oh, Markov getting a kill on Seuss that maybe he shouldn't have. It's a very nice flashbang trick there from Seuss, throwing it up on the roof and then peeking out. And Guardian, oh sorry, Markov was actually completely blind here. Guardian will pick up the kill. And can they find him in time? Seems like he's going to survive the round with about 2 seconds left. So that's an AWP save, and NaVi can still go for the buy. But if HellRaisers can win this upcoming round, again, the opening is there. They can turn this from a 7-2 into a 7-4 situation, and that would be very different for them.
It would. But by the same token, losing this round would be, again, horrible for them. But yeah, hopefully they'll be able to string consecutive rounds together now. That's really the name of the game at this point.
Alright, well, pushing down. I like the aggression out of NaVi here already, taking control of Banana. HellRaisers not really trying to push through that smoke that went down to cut it off. This is such an old play now as well. We're seeing a lot of tried and true here, but when it comes down to it, NaVi with the execution are just very clean, and it seems like HellRaisers not quite able to deal with it, or not willing to take the fight. You know, because they could push two guys through, but if you've got three guys from NaVi waiting on the other side of that smoke and Banana, it's anybody's, it's anybody's round at that point. So HellRaisers, they opt to gather up in apartments, get what map control they can, and just set up for the play that seems like it's going to be A after all.
Yeah, I'm wondering, are they ready with some smokes? Yeah, so you're definitely right. These smokes are a huge indication. They're going to go towards Library and towards Archway. So Archway, Library, and that's actually pretty good. That could result in a really great A take. They've had the most success going for A anyway, so I don't blame them for trying it again, but Guardian is going to open up, takes down Kucha, goes for the repeak, and Adrian is gone, and that's going to be a third one. Is he going to go for the 4-kill? He's looking for Markov up in those apartments, and he's not even going to get a chance. Seuss will finish off the last two. So the idea was there, but what went wrong that round? I mean, was that just Guardian shutting everything down, or did HellRaisers do something more basic wrong, do you think, Ben?
No, that's the big difference there, because that was the same strategy they did to win the first round of the game.
Yeah.
And the biggest difference is the fact that Guardian didn't go down this time. He took, a big enough safety measure for him to allow him to actually make the trek back towards the end of Arch. And from there on out, he managed to pick up three people. And obviously that's going to play in the favor of NaVi. So him actually just taking that safety precaution and just hanging just a tiny bit more back and giving himself that space to work with, that was the adjustment he needed to make that push pretty much irrelevant for HellRaisers.
Yeah, NaVi are getting very good at adjusting and playing farther back on the site, right? They know when to pace themselves with the aggression, but they also know when to really just play the site, A site in particular, and get those situations where they're just going to be able to wreak havoc. Edward, speaking of that, gets two kills up in apartments, goes for the third, but he's not going to get it. Still, the damage has been done. HellRaisers down to three men.
Yes, and Angel is going to pick up the kill, the revenge onto Edward, but it doesn't really matter. He can't put down the bomb, and they had actually bought this round. They had armor and pistols and even an AK, I think. And this kill from Edward up here, the triple, was a result of that flashbang I was talking about before. Seuss actually did it this time, and it worked pretty much perfectly. He got the kills he needed, and that was it. 9-2 here. There's still a chance for HellRaisers, but the gap is closing. We're very, very quickly approaching a point in time where HellRaisers are just going to be out of rounds to play with.
But it kind of feels like HellRaisers are imploding, because again, you see, Kucher is doing what Doge did on Dust 2. Buys up with an AK, he's going to be broke the next round, the rest of his team are on an eco.
And they can't get that kill on Guardian mid either. C's just trying to take advantage of that. I mean, Guardian spots three guys down mid. He's like, okay, C's tries to go for the spray at bottom banana and catch anybody off guard, but that's just not going to happen. Seems like it's going to be an apartments-focused play again for HellRaisers, but Edward, with the aggression, just holds it off. He holds that angle calmly, and Markloff walks into it. Now it's Angel's turn to take a beating, and Edward, he just has no fear.
A grenade follow-up, and without any armor on Angel, that can actually easily kill you with a grenade like that, so... Luckily for him, he gets to survive a little bit longer, and now he's going to be spotting out Kucha there, and actually does take him down, so that's the AK gone, and they're going to trade it, and there is even a term for this, which is called the Russian AK. We just have one guy who continuously sort of tries to do it, and when he dies, the next guy picks it up, and now would be a good time for it to work, and they are actually making their way through here. It's a 3-on-3 right now, and if they can go back and kill Starix, that'd be big.
Yeah, you really like this. You really gotta like this play here from HellRaisers. This is such a smart move because Starix is alone. Starix needs to get both of these kills, and he does it. And he's still alive on the other side of this smoke. Adrian, he knows what's happening. He's gonna try and peek through. There you go. Goes for the cheek, and he gets it done. But it takes too long. Zeus is already alive in CT, and there's no nade. There's no smoke to cut off Zeus here. Adrian should not be able to make it onto this site.
Oh, well, Zeus is covering an angle.
Sneak.
Oh, but it doesn't matter. He's still gonna peek out. He was being cheeky about it. I like that play from Adrian, but at the end, it's still 10-2. It's still a situation where HellRaisers are going to force it up again, but their economy is all over the place, isn't it?
It is, and, well, that's HellRaisers for you, I guess. It's kind of how it ends up in pretty much every game they played, regardless if it's going good or bad for them. But yeah, luckily for them, they've gotten quite a few nades to work with at this point, so I think from here on out, they need to get the remaining rounds, and this is the round to do it. This is the best opportunity they're going to get for the rest of the half.
This might well be. Grenade rains in, and Zeus is down to 70, and they've already tagged Starix up quite a bit, but they got three people holding this bomb site right now, so if HellRaisers try and push through and they kill a couple of people, they might forget about the fact that there's going to be a third guy there, and that in itself can be a pretty tricky situation, but they're slowing it down. And Na'Vi aren't really adjusting much. They're just staying where they are.
Calm. Because HellRaisers do have a bit of a stubborn streak as well. Sometimes they get into that terrier mode where they just latch their jaws onto something and then they never let go. And we see it now. HellRaisers slowly working their way up the top banana. Seized takes a peek, spots them. Is he going to make it? He makes it out alive. Seized somehow hangs in there. And that should not have been allowed.
Now look,
he should not have made it out of there in one piece.
No, and he actually goes for the flash re-peek, so he knows, Seas knows that there's no one out there now. They fell back, and look at what the rotation is now. Starix comes in, Guardian holding the angle. I think Na'Vi have a great read on what's happening right now because of that one flash peek.
They don't see anybody. They're still opting to hold two guys on B, though, so it is going to be down to the three men here defending on this A site. Edward in a good position to catch them as they try and make their way up short, but Starix is instantly going to go overwhelmed, and the crossfire set up to take out Guardian. HellRaisers have adjusted, and they just overwhelmed the defense completely on this A site. Na'Vi got a little bit too careless there.
Yeah, and also some great flashbangs, I think, getting into that site. Guardian really got... I mean, he was in the exact same position as he was a couple of rounds ago where he just killed three members, but this time they had the flashbangs to shut him out, and they got so close that it managed to work, and Markloff got so close he actually jumped on the face of, I think it was Starix, down to the pit.
I actually think one of those Edward flashes were Guardian's own.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
I'm wondering.
And he definitely missed two shots he should have hit on HellRaisers members. So, and if he picks up those two frags, I think we're going to see a similar fate as the previous round we saw where they tried a similar push towards Arch. So, unfortunate for Guardian, but very, very good if you're HellRaisers.
Right now, it still feels like it's all Na'Vi all the way, but if this finishes 10-5 and HellRaisers pick up the pistol, that's what we started off saying, 5 rounds on the pistol, that can be enough for HellRaisers to work with, and I think right now that's what they have to gun for. If they lose this round, though, they really won't have a lot to force up with for the final round, so it's still very scary for them.
Well, that it is. I mean, a lot hangs in the balance here for HellRaisers regarding the money, you're right, and also just regarding confidence. If they can close out this half with the last two rounds, 10-5 is actually kind of workable if they pick up the pistol in the second half. So HellRaisers not out of this yet. It's been a hell of a struggle so far in this first half, but they can still inflict some damage here, and Adrian just closes in the perfect flank. He goes for the double spray, takes out Zeus and Edward both.
Oh, Guardian does drop Markulov as he's jumping down, and that's actually a big difference. Now it's a 3-on-3 retake instead of a 4-on-3, and Starix is making a lot of noise coming up from behind. I'm sure Kucha must have heard that, so if Kucha kills Starix, this retake's going to be very, very tough, I think, and he should be able to do it kind of easily as well. And there it is. Now Guardian looking down the pit, almost get blocked by his teammate then. They're going to try and smoke it off, but they realize there's a chance for a backstab as well. Seast is going to go up and try and see if he can find Kucha, and Guardian actually running away, so they're not going to go for it, and I don't really blame them either. C's just looking for some exit frags here.
Yeah, and that's perfect for that. Kucha walks right into him. That was very nicely done there by Seized, but there is just not enough time to get in there and take advantage of that frag. Better to back off, hold on to the guns. Navi's economy is a little bit shaky here as well. This is something that we have to mention. They don't have mountains of cash, so them holding on to these two guns is going to make a big difference here in this round. It means that they could draw for Edward to allow Edward to get full nades, armor, you know, even a kit. But Edward is actually just going to go straight up Swag 7 because Edward has no fear.
And, I mean, on a map like Inferno, the Mag 7 is definitely a great weapon in both bomb sites. So we see Edward running towards apartments, presumably, and Starix over at the B bomb site. They work just as well on either side of the map. So this could still be scary, even though it's not the optimal equipment, maybe.
I mean, if he gets up close in apartments, he has the opportunity. Guardian held onto his op, and he's already picking up frags and banana, finds Adrian, and chases off Doja. So this is not the start that HellRaisers were hoping for here in this 15th round.
And Edward actually very close to Markulov in a weird play coming out here. He's went into bedroom, then now he's waiting, and Markulov could have instantly died then. He should consider himself very lucky. But in the meantime, they're wrapping back around. C's just going to come through and doesn't get the kill. Now that's a big problem for the remaining Na'Vi members. Seuss doing a great job. Starix picking up a kill as well. Are they really going to pull out of this? It looked like HellRaisers had such a great position. And now Seuss with another kill. Markulov goes down to Guardian. And Na'Vi win it and make it 11-4. Vendetta. Am I the only one that seemed like... It looked to me like that HellRaisers could take that round.
Oh yeah, they definitely had the opportunity to do that. I think... It's kind of unfortunate that Markulov isn't able to catch Edward off. I think he got somewhat surprised by the fact that Markulov and Edward threw that smoke off out from bedroom, basically giving away his position, but also the fact that he actually opts to just jump through randomly. If he would have been able to pick off Edward in that situation, then that could have easily been the entrance that HellRaisers needed to just run into the site, basically, because that's what they were successful with earlier on in the game. As soon as they got that one opener on one of the bomb sites, they were just able to run with it. But yeah, it didn't quite work out, and now they're pretty far behind, so they've got a bit of a mountain to climb.
Well, the thing is, I'm really impressed with Zeus's play in particular. Throughout this entire first half, he's hit shot after shot. That last one there, just the flick onto Kucha to drop the bomb carrier from HellRaisers, that was just... Zeus has just shown up big in this tournament. Guardian as well, clearly 17-1-4, a better ratio than he had on Dust 2. So if you're HellRaisers right now and you're looking at this, you're thinking, well, how do we actually deal with this? And now Seized has the opportunity to come into play and take point for Na'Vi as well here in this round, so in the second half. So it's all going to come down to this pistol right here. HellRaisers, if they want to have a chance, they have to win it.
Here it comes. If you're just joining us, then a big welcome to Room on Fire in the SLTV Starseries Finals. It's Na'Vi and HellRaisers for the second half on the second map, and Na'Vi already took Dust 2 in quite a convincing fashion. It was 16-6, I believe. And right now, HellRaisers want to make sure they at least do better than that, and I think they pretty want to make sure they actually put us onto a third map right now, because otherwise, they're going to be in the lower bracket. They won't be out of the tournament, but the lower bracket is always more difficult.
That's when the pressure is on, right? That's when it gets out of hand. But Edward manages to rush down Doja. Kucha has found a frag as well, picking off Guardian. But it's still a 4-on-4 situation here. A lot of nades have been used, and Zeus roasting for a little bit there. That's a bit dangerous.
Yeah, Markulov here is actually the only one holding A right now. They can't get the bomb up there. That's the big thing. Zeus is stuck in T-spawn almost with the bomb. Markulov is getting wrapped around. Can they find him? Edward is so close. This is such a strange game right now. Seuss is ready and waiting. He's going to shoulder peek Adrian a little bit with the knife out to make it even faster. Action is all over the place. Starix is going to pick up Markulov. That gives them the bomb site, but they've lost the bomb down towards the Vietnam grave, and Angel is going to go down. I've never seen a pistol round just this chaotic.
Oh, nicely done there by Adrian. Clicks away Edward, and now it's Starix who's picked up a USP. goes for the flash. Adrian is completely white, but he can't get through the smoke in time to take advantage of it. And this is all HellRaisers now. This is their situation. They're around to lose. Kuchar spots Starix out at the edge of the smoke, tries to put some shots through on him, but they just have to double down on this. They just have to sit on this position. The bomb is an underpass, and Starix is getting nowhere near it.
Oh, he's on just 3 points of health, and it's only 15 seconds left, so he doesn't really have a lot of time. He's actually going to have to go for the kills, I think. And right now, they're in even better positions to deny him that, so he realizes he's going to have to man up here. He runs in and tries to find the first one, but smart play from HellRaisers, and Kuchar in particular with a 4 kill in this one round. It makes it 11-5, so, okay, 4 rounds and the pistol. It can still happen. They can still come back.
They need to win the 19th round now. The next hurdle, or actually for HellRaisers, this round here is a hurdle as well, because they have struggled with anti-eco rounds in the past, not really figuring out how to properly deal with the CZ and the aggression that can come out, the quick aggression that can come out with that pistol. So we'll have to see now. Doja's just rushing down with the MP7. He gets overwhelmed. Guardian and Zeus each getting frags, but luckily Adrian is there to plug the gap. Edward is trying to hunt them, but it's into a 3-on-3 now, and what's worse is Na'Vi now have some guns to use.
Yeah, you said it just before it happened, and I think the big thing is this MP7 is great against unarmored targets, but because Na'Vi had armor, and HellRaisers should have been able to predict that, it just does a lot less, and we saw him take a fight against 3 armored targets and came up very, very short.
Well, the reason why you're going for that, in case, you know, the money system, right? It's all about the money system, yeah. Basically. So you're trying to get those easy kills on unarmored targets, because with an MP7, you're getting $600 per kill versus the $300 you would get with a rifle. So Doja, you know, it's like an educated, you know, guess, risk, whatever. He's just hoping to get out a bit ahead. If somebody's rushing up banana, he cuts down two, he gets $1,200. Just didn't work out this time for him.
Markolov is going to get Molotov'd out of pit for a little bit, and they're really close to him here. Edward will pick up the kill, and now that's definitely the bomb plant coming in here for Na'Vi. Now, whether or not they can hold it is a different question, because Starix is very low here. Grenade doesn't land on the right target. Seized is going to survive. If that had been Starix in the pit, it would have been a 2-on-2. They do not have a kit picked up either, so the clock's really working against HellRaisers. Now they're rushing in him. Adrian cannot find the kill. He just spots a heal around the corner, but can't actually see anyone enough to get the kill. Kucha's going to be rushing through. That's a great shot through the door here, or through the box, and that's going to be the end. MP7 comes back to haunt them, takes down Kuchar as the last man, and Na'Vi bounce right back, and that's a disaster for HellRaisers.
That's a nice way of putting it.
Yeah.
Somebody needs to play that Toby clip right now. This is a disaster! Because that's what happened right there. That's really, really... And adding insult to injury, Edward gets the last kill with the MP7. Like, that is just rude, Edward, man. That is really just rude.
We could just invite Toby on here, because I know he's watching the other day, and we've modded him in the chat and everything, so maybe we should just do that.
You've given Toby...
Given Toby the
mod?
Power?
Yeah, I have.
What have you done?
Well... You know, he's a small guy. If he does anything wrong, you know, I'll find him on LAN. I bet I can take Toby in a fight. It'll be all right. We'll settle like that. It's going to be the 18th round coming up. And Markolov right here on the stairs inside the apartments is going to take down Starix. So that's a fine opening, but HellRaisers are miles away from a victory right now.
Still holding angles and holding the important ones as well. 3 guys on this A site makes it very difficult to close the gap without just getting gunned down, especially now that HellRaisers have 2 rifles to work with. They managed to spot a man out on Speedway. That's Zeus, who is poking forward towards that B site. Angel instantly reacting, trying to choose a different angle to hold from. But Na'Vi are kind of split up, and Markolov just gets the perfect timing to catch Seized, trying to go through banana.
So a bit of a... You know, switcheroo coming out here. Zeus takes a dink to the face from Angel in the back of sight, and Guardian, he's kind of trapped in a weird corner here. Will take down Angel, and that'll be the end of it. So, a good bounce back from HellRaisers. Be interesting if they could make the comeback. I mean, right now they're 6 rounds behind, but the important thing to note is that these aren't 6, you know, they don't have to necessarily be 6 buy rounds from Na'Vi, right? It may be that Na'Vi can only buy, you know, three or four out of these rounds, depending on how many bomb plants they get. So
I love what Na'Vi do, though.
Yeah, they force up now. So even if they lose this round, then you probably get a freebie in the upcoming round. So that's definitely a big part, or a big deal for HellRaisers at this point. Now they just need to defend versus this wonky eco.
Yeah, they do have a lot of people over here on Banana. It's actually going to work out great for them. They only lose Angel. Even though that looked really scary, it looked like they were being overpowered again. But this time they managed to... They reset the situation. And Starix is going to scavenge an AK, but not sure that makes a really big difference here. He hasn't got enough time, I think, either to really run around and save it. So we'll see what comes of it.
At this point, I think he's just waiting to see if anybody's going to get impatient on Hellraiser's side. Peek out, give him a free shot, that sort of thing, because running up Banana, there's two guys holding it, and they even have smokes. They have more smokes on Hellraiser's side to just buy more time, basically. They're going to just completely take Banana away from Starx. Flash goes in, Starx is blind, he's standing around the pillar, Doja can't see him quite yet, but instantly Doja, with the headshot, as soon as Starx shows himself. So, very, very fine hold. You have to admire how well Hellraisers played the angles there, and Banana just not shooting into each other, falling back, and just constantly shutting the door in Navi's face, not allowing Navi to push around the angle that would have got them up to car.
So, 5-round difference, 12-7, and this time Navi have no choice. They have to eco, and are they having a team meeting here, or are they just admiring this chicken house?
Listening to the music. They're letting the music speak to their souls.
Does SLTV have timeouts?
I don't think so.
Okay, so then it's probably what we saw. Well, I guess it was Titan doing, at the beginning. It's something that Existence brought over from what he did during his time in Rare Games and Source. Which basically, if you have to talk things over, use the eco rounds to just get everything sorted before the next buy round.
Mm-hmm.
And
I kind of hope that tournaments will implement the timeout rule as well. The ones that we had at Gamescom, because I found that to be really interesting when teams could, you know, actually take a 3-minute timeout and just talk over things and use it in different ways. You know, if they were ahead to break momentum, if they were behind to figure out what's going wrong.
Yeah, I think I like the fact that you have the opportunity to actually adjust and talk things over, but I don't like the fact that you're allowed to take a timeout basically to ruin the momentum for the other team.
Mind games, man. Mind games.
Yeah, I don't like that aspect of it, that you can basically say, like, oh, they're on a hot streak. Well, F you guys.
Oh, I'll unplug my mouse.
Now we're just going to take a pause and we're going to sit around and drink water for 3 minutes.
Well, yeah, I mean, maybe there's some adjustments to be done. It's an interesting concept. Anyway, what I wish is that if there were timeouts, I wish we could listen in on the timeouts with the translator and everything so we could know what the hell they were talking about. That would be fun.
But what now was it when we did that for Na'Vi, remember? And they were like, oh, I want a Red Bull. You know, they were just... It was just the most innocuous stuff. Like, they weren't even really strategizing. It was just
Look at this. Adrian rushing down and actually will pick up the first kill, even though he did get a lot of grenade damage on him by a teammate there. Right now, Na'Vi are not really making a breakthrough over here on Banana. Angel's going to re-peek and will take down Guardian as well. Edward next in line, and he will finally open up, but it's probably too late. 2-on-3 right now for Na'Vi to make a breakthrough right here. They need to even it out and make it 2-2.
And Hellraisers, all they have to do is sit back and hold the angles at this point, not peek forward. They don't need to get information. They have the man advantage. I mean, right now it's kind of Kuchar who's slowly slinking his way closer to the top of Banana to see if anybody's going to be peeking around there. But I'd much rather, you know, the position that Doja's holding, for example, is over in Noob Corner. He's going to manage to pick up the frag on Starix, who has to come around that corner basically to try and get around to A site. And Doja now will spot out Edward. So really nice clean play there from Doja. 1-on-1, manages to win both duels and puts Hellraisers on 9 rounds now. Na'Vi have got to be wondering, actually, is this starting to slip out of our grasp? Because 3 rounds is not that much when we're talking CT side Inferno.
Well, go on. If I come home to this, if I just joined GoTV or was watching on the stream and I see this scoreline, 12-9, and somebody tells me who's going to be winning it, I'd say Hellraisers. 3-round difference on the CT side, and looking at the economy as well, I would say Hellraisers have a greater chance of winning it. The only thing that makes me not say that is the history that we've seen on the first half and on Dust 2. That makes me think, oh, you know, now we've been playing so well, but you know, Hellraisers, they have the manpower to do this.
Do you agree, Ben?
Yeah, absolutely. Hellraisers are in a really good spot now. They've managed to get back into this, really. And as long as they don't lose this to this eco, they're definitely in a favorable position, in my opinion.
Yeah, I mean, especially if they come out of this round with everyone alive, that's going to put Kuchar on the good side of 10,000, and the same for Markolov. That's a lot of money to work with, and Na'Vi have to win not just, you know, a couple of rounds, but well, they have to basically just finish the game almost before Hellraisers are going to be ecoing.
Yeah, that's the scary part. Basically, Hellraisers would be ecoing when it was well, too late, basically, for them to be able to hold on to it. NaVi are setting up for a smoke.
Oh, a little bit of robot. There's
plenty of smokes, and now we have to see them go. Once this smoke clears, are they going to be able to overwhelm the defense? Because that's what's going to be crucial here.
And all these smokes should hopefully at least provide them with a bomb plant, because otherwise they've wasted a fair bit of money doing it. And they do smoke off the front of the bomb site, which is something that we often identify with the Fnatic kind of play. Kucha here looking for the crossover kill, and actually the bomb is going to be planted by Seized here. So it's all worth it at the end. They may have spent a lot of money, but they get even more back with that bomb plant. So great job from NaVi. That was all they wanted to do.
I like to see that teams are really using these Fnatic plays. Like, that's remember how crazy we got when we saw that? Wasn't that before Katowice that we saw Fnatic go for that kind of play the first time?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
It was actually the week before Katowice.
Yeah.
Because
we were flipping out because we were like, oh man, Pronex, you dirty dog, you're coming up with all these sneaky smoke plays, you know, A site, B site, he had them all.
Yeah, and then, and that was also, I remember watching that, and then Valve patching one of the smoke bugs with the one-way smokes that were also starting to get popular, and Pronex got a bit miffed about that because he said he had tons of stuff planned out for Katowice regarding those smokes.
Yeah, sad times for Pronex, but he's proven that he can adjust. I mean, they did make it to the semifinals, or the grand final, sorry, at Gamescom, so it's not like, you know, that one thing really crippled Fnatic, luckily. Right now it's 12-10, HellRaisers. They need to keep winning like they have already. There's a lot of money on their side. Kucha, actually, the room is literally on fire. He's going to burn to death. And that's a great opening. But Doja does return it. And that's important. Otherwise, they could have lost a lot of control on the map. But now it's sort of back to square one.
Square one, 4-on-4. And Angel manages to catch Guardian off guard at mid. That's going to open things up here for HellRaisers. NaVi, they don't have any target to reply on quickly here. So they are going to have to deal with this with being a man down. They still have some smokes, though, and a Molotov, so it makes me think that they might want to go towards this A site. They're going to go faking it. I mean, Zeus is going to try and make it look like it's going to be a B play, and actually, it is going to be a B play. They gather up, and now we have to see a great headshot onto Angel, but he's not going to get it.
Angel falls back into a slightly safer position, and Adrian behind the new boxes, and this is going to be really tough for NaVi. They're going to try and go for it anyway here. 10 seconds left. They know Adrian is back here. 8 seconds. They're going to have to push. Quick Seize goes down. They still have to deal with Angel, and they will kill him, and I don't think there's enough time.
No time.
Oh, no. They lose the round because the time runs out, and then they lose Seuss as well, which is even worse because now he gets no money for losing that round, whereas the rest of his team does. At least they save the AK on Starix, so they could do something here, but HellRaisers, they're back in this game. They are gunning for that third map, and the way it's going right now, they might just get to it.
Yeah, and this is what we talked about prior to the game starting, with NaVi being such a slow-paced team. Obviously, they were down two men at this point, but when they execute so late into the rounds, all HellRaisers need to do is basically pick off the guy with the bomb, and from there on and out, they're golden.
Yeah, no, you don't have the time to be able to reposition yourself as well. That's the main thing, is that NaVi, they had to waste time getting around the fountain because they lost control of CT. Doja using a really cool smoke that he's been using more and more often here. It's going to give him an angle to work on, look towards Starix. And there you go, Starix gets dropped down to half, and no opportunity for him to reply either. Doja has really put a lot of work into it. I haven't actually seen anybody else go for that smoke in particular.
That's good news, but now Guardian has remembered. Isn't there just something about me being pretty good with the AWP? Maybe we should use that. And that's a nice idea, just using him to slowly wedge yourself into the map and towards the A bomb site. And look at how defensive HellRaisers are playing as a result on this A bomb site. Now they're all very, very far back towards the bomb site. And that can be good and bad. If they lose the entry frag right now, if they lose one more person at this A bomb site, I think it's going to be very tough for them to hold.
Yeah, but look at HellRaisers. They're betting it all on this A side, actually. They've rotated the extra man over. Adrian is no longer at the B side. It's all a Hoocher around the angle. Double headshot from Zeus. And Doja gets spotted out on the balcony. Stark should be able to overwhelm him, and he does it. This is falling apart now. HellRaisers down to two men.
Yeah, 20 seconds left. So actually, now we have to go for the bomb side. Otherwise, they could rotate back. But there's so little time left here. And Adrian's going to pick off one. Now it's Markolov. And again, the time is a factor. 10 seconds here. Guardian has to go for the plant right now. Molotov in the back here. Markolov comes up, but he can actually just deny it. Guardian, 4 seconds, 3 seconds. Markolov, is he going to save his team? He's going for it, and he will do it. The triple kill, and HellRaisers now all the way back. 12-12, they've equalized the score. What a round. NaVi, so close, but they can't do it.
Ben. NaVi do like to cut it close. Holy hell.
Yeah, I mean, I was thinking that Markloff would get pinned down by Starks, but Starks had so little HP, he couldn't take the fight. Yeah. And so Markloff manages to sneak out and turn it into that 1v1 situation. If Guardian gets up there and just goes for the straight plant while Markloff is in the back corner like that and Starks has oversight, then that totally changes everything, because Markloff can't get in position to stop the plant. But as soon as Starks is gone from the equation, Guardian loses all control. Edward trying to sneak out from Boiler gets caught by Kucher at top mid. And now NaVi down a man, down on gear as well. They don't have a whole lot. This was a force buy from them.
From an 11-4 scoreline to a 12-12 scoreline, that's what HellRaisers have accomplished so far. And right now, they just need four more rounds on the CT side to make it work. Kucha, though, now defending, is going to go down, seized and Guardian, and oh my god, just as we're talking about it, the A bomb site is just obliterated now. It's down in the pit with Doja here, 1-on-3 for him, and he's going to go down, leaving Adrian to try and clutch a 1-on-2, and this is not like Markloff's situation at all. They have time to plant and time to get into better positions, but... Oh, there's Guardian with the 8k shot. That actually still got really scary. Adrian, if he had been quick enough, maybe could have done it. But that's 13 to 12. Still a ton of money on HellRaiser's side. They can buy for quite a while, but NaVi at least get a little bit closer.
That was really scary there for NaVi. Adrian, I mean, getting gifted headshots, basically. I'm not sure why Seized, after confirming where Adrian was, decided to peek out again like that and just give Adrian the opportunity to shoot him in the face.
That was a bit of a questionable decision from Seized. Luckily for him, Guardian manages just to salvage the round for them. But it plays a big part as to how the next round plays out, because two of the NaVi members are on Galils, and that's obviously not what you want to have when you're buying up in such a big round. And if Seized had survived that previous round, he probably would have been able to drop off an AK for either Starks or Edward.
Yeah, agreed.
Nice shot through the smoke here. Adrian tank Seized down to 10 points of health over by Banana, so it's really annoying for him. Actually, if HellRaisers lose this round, at least two of their members won't be able to buy that much. I mean, Markloff could probably drop for one of them. And maybe even a FAMAS for another one, but this is very critical at this point. Both teams are at a point where they gotta win rounds, or they're either gonna win or lose altogether.
Money right now, money is crucial, you're right. I mean, there's still a good bank, but yeah, for HellRaisers that is, at least on one member, but that's not a whole lot. That's gone in the space of a couple rifles. So NaVi now sneaking their way around. Still 30 seconds left, and I'm still not getting stressed out. That's what's weird about NaVi. They're going to wait until the very last second to go.
Yeah, and it's going to be an A-play, in fact. So this is all faking it out right now. Smokes and flashes into the bombsite, but luckily, HellRaisers aren't inching away. They stay at the A-bombsite. They realize what's up here. Markloff defending downstairs. 10 seconds left. Are they going to go for the plant right away? Seuss gets another kill. Markloff is going to pick up one. There's 6 seconds, and the bomb is dropped here. Markloff wins it again. There's no chance any longer. He's going to pick up another kill here. And Seized, well, he'll get one, but he goes down once again after the time is out, which is actually a big tactical error from Seized. He had to run away and save then instead of going for more kills. It's 13-13. And NaVi lose a second round now to the time running out.
Yeah. They're cutting it too close.
I actually think Guardian made a mistake right there, because he, after the first guy got taken out by Markloff on site there, he actually pulled up the bomb as he was running up into the site. So that gave Guardian just enough time for him to take out Guardian. And I think if Guardian had run up there with an AK in hand, then that would have been an easy kill and an easy plant for NaVi.
And I think the name of the game this round for HellRaisers is basically a flawless round. They got to look to not lose a single member right here, because if by chance NaVi pick up, well, not this round, but the next one, HellRaisers need a big buffer, economically speaking, to be able to bring it back straight away. So everyone surviving this round for HellRaisers, I think, would put them just on the edge of taking the second map.
Agreed. No, they would have a very strong shot at it. They would all have a good buffer, a good bank. Zeus finding one shot onto Markloff, though. Starks will get picked off. Doja still holding on short, falling back into pit, and Angel is now going to take a peek of his own. This could be a big opportunity here for NaVi to get shredded. Angel with the triple as they try and make their way out from Boiler. And that is just going to be NaVi walking away with only one frag. And I don't think that's quite good enough. They needed two there.
Yeah, and Seized, look at this. The fact that he went down that one round after the time was run out is now coming back to haunt him, because now he's got a C-set and armor and grenades instead of, you know, the rifles he could have had with the rest of his team. So that's the, that's sort of the aftermath of what happened a couple of rounds ago. It really does all tie together, especially when you come down to the 28th round like we're in now.
So many nades used at top and enter right now. Just flambe, smoke, flashes, but Guardian doesn't care. He walks up short and manages to pick up one. Doja's been spotted in apartments. Kuchar coming in to support from Guardian's usual spot. Flashes everywhere, and NaVi getting caught in their tracks, but Guardian opening it up again, getting a second frag and a third, and Guardian, with the help of his team, just makes it happen.
And Adrian missing a big opportunity to kill Seized, and Seized not killing him either. I have no idea what kind of battle that was, but Angel's going to be alone, and he's picking up people left and right. Still no bomb pump, but it's plenty of time, and Angel's going to go down this game. It's down to the wire. It's 14-14. And whoever loses this upcoming... Well, actually, if NaVi lose this upcoming round, they can still buy and fight for overtime. But if HellRaisers lose it, I think they're going to be ecoing. Then Navi's going to make it 16-14. And no, I'm not... I spoke too soon. They actually use all their money on Navi's side, too. Whoever wins this round probably wins this map.
It's so close. Yeah. Whoever wins this round is going to get a gift basket in the final round of the game. That's pretty much how it is.
Oh my god. What a game. And you know what really switched it up for NaVi that round was how aggressive they were. I mean, they pushed before, you know, there was still a minute left on the clock. That's highly unlikely for NaVi to do that, and it may have caught HellRaisers off guard. They just weren't ready for that kind of fast push from this terrorist side.
That's the power of NaVi. You train your opponents to wait until, you know, they're not going to expect you until there's 20 seconds left on the clock, and then you go at them at a minute 30. And all of a sudden, that change of pace, it works. Guardian showing us what's possible when he takes point and decides to get the job done. Angel in library is getting sprayed down. Starx is going to have the opportunity to go for a big frag as well. Drops down Angel to low, but Angel will be there to stop them from rotating in through Arch.
Yeah, great work so far from HellRaisers. See if they can get that third map home. Adrian in the back, straight headshot onto Seize, looking very good right now. Guardian low on health. Adrian doing tremendous work. He's finally going to get shut down. And Seize, well, they have to kill Angel before they can actually get this bomb plant. He's going to try for it once, and Angel shooting through the smoke, can't quite find the angle. So it will be a retake, but because Starix and Guardian are so low, I still feel like this should be HellRaisers' chance to take it and make it to a map point here.
No, they have no more smokes, though. They have no more nades to stop this from coming in. No nades on HellRaisers either. They just had the one. Guardian finds the headshot on Angel to start. But Doja is currently just working his way onto the site. There's Zeus with a headshot. Brings it back to a 2-on-2, and they're still alive. Kuchar has to rush him down. Finally gets rid of Zeus, only to lose his teammate to Starx.
Oh, he's going to look for Starx on the corner, and he picks up the kill. Starx with the double, and that wins the round for NaVi, and now HellRaisers. Now they're very close to being knocked down to the lower bracket. That was a huge 3-on-4 fight that NaVi just took with two of their members on less than 30 points of health. Vendetta, how on earth did NaVi come out on top?
Some great movement coming out from, I can't remember who it was. Who was trapped on the site together with Guardian?
Zeus?
Yeah. Was it Zeus? Yeah, Zeus did just a masterful job of evading every HellRaisers member that came looking for him, and he managed to pick up a kill in addition to that, actually, I don't think he picked up a kill, but he bought enough time for Starx to pick up the guy coming in from pool. Yeah. And he just did everything there to buy time for NaVi, and Guardian picking up the one frag on, I think, Kuchar through the smoke there, coming through coils, that was massive as well.
Aggressive movement from HellRaisers up in the apartments here. Edward does peek. He's got to be careful. There's someone right behind him, but actually, he still picks up the kill, and Markolov is going to finally retaliate onto Starx, but this A bomb site is very, very weak. If NaVi realize, and now I think they will realize, they've already killed two people here, and they're going to go for it. This is going to be an almost impossible retake. HellRaisers might have to dip into the lower bracket here unless Adrian can pull out a 1-on-3. And
it's not meant to be.
Not meant to be. Guardian ending up at 31 kills and just 30 rounds. That's a kill per round and then some. All right. What a sick game. All 30 rounds.
Not too shabby. And again, for NaVi, Seize and Guardian coming up big. Really big. Seize was also playing exceptionally well on Dust 2, and that bodes well for them going into it. Because we talked about Seize at the beginning of the game, but he didn't have to play as big as we've seen him do in recent times. And if he turns it on as well, then holy hell, Fnatic are in for a hell of a treat.
And speaking of which, guys, that is our next match coming up. It's Fnatic and NaVi in the winners match here. And none teams are out yet. Tomorrow we're gonna continue, of course, but today we still have this match coming up. It will be another break here about an hour and a half before we're back with Fnatic and NaVi. So if you want to help out us here on the channel, then all you have to do is put it on low quality and stick around and watch a few ads, and we really do appreciate that. You can even just mute. You don't have to listen to the ads or anything. If you want to do that, then we definitely appreciate it. But otherwise, we'll be back in an hour and a half with a really sick match. So stay tuned and enjoy yourselves here. Thank you for tuning in so far, and we'll be back soon enough.